is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my bed. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my bed. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my bed. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my bed. And I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering.
Jesus, thank the Lord for this opportunity to speak His word and to be here. It's such a privilege, and I don't take it for granted to stand before the children of God. And because each one of you is a child of God, if you are born again, you become a son of God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And I thank God. Yesterday was my birthday, and I take it. God has given me a chance to speak to His children the first day of my life when I'm older, and I thank God. In the house, may you be on your feet, please, and let's worship the Lord. When I was preparing this message, the Lord told me that we need to have time to tell Him how much we love Him. I will welcome my sister. I want us to tell the Lord how much we love Him. If you know what God has done for you, if you really know what Jesus Christ did for you, when He died on the cross and He rose again, that you might have life and have it in abundance, may you stand up. I want us to worship the Lord for who He is. Tell Him. I want us to have that 5 minutes of our time to tell the Lord that we love Him. Tell Him from the bottom of your heart how much you love Him. Because God wants to hear how much you love Him. I've been in a relationship for quite a time, and I know how important it is for somebody to tell you how much they love you. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And we are in a relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise be to God.
Amen.
I want us to tell Him that we love Him. We love Him for everything that He did for us. When He died on the cross in Calvary, when He took our sins, that we can be called the children of the Most High God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Take your time. Don't look at anybody, don't look at the children, don't look at your neighbor, just look at Jesus. Look at Him, because He's the only one who knows you. He's the only one who loves you. He's the only one who cares for you. He cares for you more than any other person cares for you. Praise be to God. Please take time and praise the Lord. I realized that God loves me, He has blessed me, He has favored me, and I love Him so much. I don't know where I would be if it was not for God. And that's why when I'm in my room, I just sit down and think, and imagine the many people in our college who don't know Jesus. They have never experienced the love that Jesus gives. For me, one thing I'm sure about is the love of God.
Amen.
It's a love that you can never imagine. Don't worry if I cry, but I know that there's a person who loves like no other. There's no love that can get to the love of Jesus.
Amen.
And that's why I beg you, my brothers and sisters. There's a reading I was reading in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. And it was saying that God was in Jesus reconciling us to Himself.
And right now, Paul was saying, we beg them to be reconciled to God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
There's nothing else than being reconciled to our Father. There's no love like our Father's love. Oh, there's no love like His love.
Amen.
You can go everywhere searching for another love, but you can never find a love like the Lord's love. He loved you. When the Word of God says He loved us, that when we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
When you read in the book of Romans, it says that we who are not a people, He has called us to be a people. Praise be to God.
Amen.
John, in 1 John chapter 3 says, verse 1, behold what manner of love the Father has loved us, that we are called His sons.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
If you've never come to such a beautiful relationship with Jesus, I want you to just think about it. I don't know how much I can tell you that God is real. He's more real than we are today. He's more real than anything else in the world. Praise be to God.
Amen.
He's watching over us right now.
Amen.
You know, He says in 2 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9, that the eyes of the Lord move to and fro through the earth. He's looking, and He wants to see those whose heart is perfect towards Him, that He may strengthen them. I'm paraphrasing that. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And when I remember that, I know the world has not seen in the high heart what God has prepared. I know who I am in God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
I know I'm unstoppable. We must tell people about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
That's why I'm not ashamed. I'm never ashamed of being associated with Jesus Christ, because I knew He wasn't ashamed for me. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Today, talking about rooted in His Word. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Rooted in His Word. So we are going to go through the scripture reference that I was given. It's Psalms 119, verse 74. Don't mind me. I love the Word of God, and most of my preaching is going to be the Word of God. And it's because we are learning about the Word of God, being rooted in His Word. Praise be to God. So we are going to go through the scriptures here. Why are we supposed to be rooted in His Word? How we can train ourselves to be rooted in His Word? And we are going to study about the consequences of not being rooted in the Word of God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want witnesses in the house. I was telling my brother Kome that I came to work with people not, I love people encouraging me when I'm talking.
Amen.
So please say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Tell me amen and I'll continue. Praise be to God. I know that the Lord is going to be glorified because He's the one who's speaking to us. Even myself, I'm being spoken to. So let's preach together. Encourage me and I encourage you. Praise
amen.
Be to God.
Amen.
The Lord of Ecclesiastes, He says, iron sharpeneth iron. Praise be to God.
Amen.
So we are sharpening one another. When you tell me amen, I'm sharpened. And when I tell you a word, you're sharpened. Praise be to God.
Amen.
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 And you know one thing, the condition that is there, if you don't say amen, I say as many amens as possible.
Yes.
And you're going to stay 50 minutes and Kitake is going to be upset. So allow me not to upset. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So our first reading is going to be from Psalms 119, verse 74. They that fear thee, I love King James, so that's King James. You can use your Bible, but I love it. I think I just love the thee and the thou. That's it. They that fear thee will be glad when they see me, because I have hoped in thy word. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Colossians 2:6-7 says, as you have therefore received Christ Jesus, the Lord, so walk ye in Him, rooted and built up in Him, established in faith, as you have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Praise be to God.
Amen.
As you have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so do what? Walk ye in Him. Praise be to God.
Amen.
I want us to encourage each other so that the Spirit, I know the Spirit is working in us. Let's encourage one another. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Walk ye in Him. Praise be to God. Walk ye in Him. I want you to get that. Walk in Him. Rooted and built up in Him. Established in the faith, as you have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Praise be to God.
Amen.
In Joshua 1:18,
1:8, it says, "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou may observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success." Praise be to God.
Yeah.
What should the book of the law not do? It should not depart out of thy mouth. But thou shalt meditate therein day and night. You shall meditate therein day and night. That thou may observe to do. To do what?
To do.
According to all. According to
all.
I want us to note that. According to all. That is written therein. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Thou shalt may observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Ningemalizia preaching hapo, say I'm good.
Yeah.
What does the word of God say? When we are rooted in the word, when we meditate on the word day and night, and observe to do according to all that is written therein, then shall make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt, and you shall have good success. Praise be to God.
Yeah.
Deuteronomy 6:6. Says, "And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thy heart, and you shall teach them diligently unto your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up." Praise be to God.
Yeah.
Is not a powerful statement for us who are waiting for relationship after the service? And all of us anyway, because we all go talk to you.
Yeah.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
"And shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up. And shall bind them for a sign upon thy hand, and they shall be as frontlets between thy eyes." Praise be to God.
Amen.
I want us to note the word of God. I pray that the word of God is going to speak to us, because the word of God is spirit and is life. Praise be to God.
Amen.
The word tells us that we are supposed to talk about them when we sit. When you're sitting in your room, talk about it. When you walk by the way, talk about the word of God. When you lie down, talk about it. When you're rising up, you know there's something for the 6 years over here, there's something called hypopompic and hallucinations. Praise be to God. And these hallucinations are the hallucinations that come before you sleep and before you wake up. Praise be to God. So now the word of God is telling us that we should hallucinate with the word of God when we are sleeping, hallucinate with the word of God when we are sleeping. This is what he said. When you get to mental health, you're going to be told out many things about the word of God, but we use it for advantage. You know, the word of God says that the word of God is foolishness to those who take themselves to my Savior. But for us, we know it's the power of God unto salvation. Praise be to God.
Amen.
So now, you should have this hallucination. I'm putting it in quotes. As if you're thinking about the word of God. When you're lying down, when you're raising up, the only thing that you're thinking about is the word of God. "And you shall bind them for a sign unto thy hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes." Imagine that. I wish I would read from NIV. I'm sure it puts it better. It should be just before your eyes. When everywhere you're going, the word of God is there. Praise be to God.
Amen.
"And you shall write them upon the post of thy house." Praise be to God. What does that mean? "And thy gates." As in, like, in my room, I should put the word of God there, such that when I'm entering in, it's the word of God I see.
Amen.
When I'm getting out, it is the word of God I see.
Amen.
In my gate, I should put the word of God there, such
Amen.
That everywhere I am, the word of God is with me. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And the word of God is life. That's what Jesus Christ said. It is spirit and it is life. Praise be to God.
Amen.
That is what we need to understand. Why it is very important for us to be rooted in his word. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Next. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Is God good?
Yes.
Is God good in our lives?
So much.
I know he's very good. For me, I know that there's no God but him. Next, please. When you look at that picture, what do you think about? When I saw it, you know what I thought about? I know there are beautiful places, but I thought about how beautiful heaven is going to be.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
I just imagined how, you know, it's not that pretty as it is, but it was so pretty in my comb. And and I thought how beautiful it is for brethren to dwell together in unity.
Amen.
How beautiful it is when we
are going to be meeting in those streets of gold, and we are saying, Shrek, how are you? Nelly, how are you? You remember those days when you said, courage one another, praise be to God.
Amen.
And we are going there. We'll go there by being rooted in the word of God. Praise be to God. So please ensure that I meet you, because we are going to be in heaven anyway. And I know, as if that's something I'm sure about.
Amen.
Please, let me tell you something. Don't trade heaven for anything. You know, people fear when you talk about heaven and hell. But for me, I know. That's why Paul and these apostles would say, encourage one another concerning these things, which we hope for. You know, the part that, you know, this life cannot be compared to eternity. Yay! I tell you, when I sit down and I remember where I'm going to be with my Jesus, I'm not going to be stopped. That's why you need to forgive. Don't hold people in your heart. Forgive so that you go. There is a better place that God has set for us as His children. Christ, God grants you favor. For me, when there's something I learned that you need always to tell yourself you're blessed, you're favored every day. Because that's who you are in God. God has blessed you. If you're associated with His Son, Jesus Christ, you know, God says we are choirs with Him. We are the sons of God. He's the firstborn of many brethren. Praise be to God. Amen. So we belong to Jesus. Just know who you are. Say you're blessed. And this comes with being rooted in the Word of God. Amen. The Word is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
John 1:1. I'm sure we know that scripture. I'm not going to read it. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was
God.
The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. When you get rooted in the Word of God, you get the light of life. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Your paths are supposed to shine. That's why I believe Jesus told us, you're the light of the world. You know why? Because the Word is light. And now when the light comes to us, we become also light. Praise be to God.
Amen.
That's why He says, you're the light of the world. A city built upon the hill cannot be hidden. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And then He asks us, when you light a candle, do you hide it at the bushel? No, you put it on the table. That can give light to men. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And that's what God wants from each one of us. When you get rooted to the Word of God, you become the light to your world. Praise
Amen.
Be to God. God desires for you to be the light of your world, to influence those who do not know Him. Because it's the will of God that all men come to the knowledge of truth. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And not perish. And He has given you the responsibility to light those who are around you. Praise be to God.
Amen.
In Revelation 19:13, it says, and He was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and His name is called what?
The Word of God.
His name is called who?
The Word of God.
So you are skinny in water. His name was called who?
The Word of God.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Jesus is called the Word of God. So when we are talking about being rooted in the Word of God, being rooted in His Word, essentially we are speaking about being rooted in Christ Jesus. Praise
Amen.
Be to God.
Amen.
Being rooted when you're not movable. I love the Word of God, which says, those who trust in God, they are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
And then the Word of God says, just as Jerusalem is surrounded by mountains, so God surrounds them that trust in Him. Oh, and I think about that. That I'm surrounded by God. You know, God surrounds you everywhere. He is with you. He says, it's like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken. Those who trust in Him, we are movable. That's why we need to as in tell people about Jesus Christ. Because you are movable, there is nothing they can do. Hallelujah. I tell you, why be rooted? Why be rooted? First of all, there is no order of preference in this. So you put them the way they can, not that there is any order. Source of all wisdom. There is wisdom that works. The wisdom that we have, we get in books, that essentially is not wisdom. They talk, you know, I wonder, when you read in Genesis chapter 26, we are told, God told Isaac not to move to the land of Egypt when famine was there. He told him to stay. And we are told when he planted, he reaped 100-fold. You can imagine how that worked out. There is a wisdom that comes from God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Have you ever thought when God told, when the children of Israel were moving through the Red Sea and it just stuck, as in when Moses striked alipiga maji and it became, we are told it became like words. Praise be to God.
Amen.
What is that? There is something which is beyond the human thinking, the human wisdom. Imagine when the children of Israel, they are facing Jericho, and these the walls of Jericho surrounding them. And they shout, and the walls of Jericho come down. What in our thinking? Imagine we can shout and this building come down. Okay, it can happen anyway because it happened then. But imagine, even right now if we shout, if it is not through that inspiration, that cannot happen. There's a wisdom from God. And the wisdom of God, that's why God says, the foolishness of God is wiser than men. The weakness of God is stronger than men. Praise be to the witness of God is stronger than men. Yeah. Praise be to God. There is a wisdom that surpasses every human wisdom. And this is found from the word of God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
We are told in Colossians 2:3, in who are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And then in him all the fullness dwells. You know, I love her. Acts 17:28, if I'm not wrong. It says, in him I live, I move, and I have my being. And in him we find our consistency. When I think about that, in him I live, I move, and I have my being. And in Christ Jesus does all the fullness dwell. Because the word of God tells us it pleased God that in Christ Jesus all the fullness would dwell. Praise be to God.
Amen.
There is nowhere else you can find completion. The word of God also says in that Colossians that we are complete in him. We are complete in Jesus Christ. There is nowhere else you can find completion in. Not in a relationship, not in your parents, not in education, not in so many degrees. No. The fullness and completion comes from Jesus Christ. And he's our Lord. He is our Savior. And he's our firstborn. I tell you, Jesus is my brother. Is he your brother?
Oh, yes.
If you are born again, he's your brother. And in him, all fullness dwells. We are told he made the heaven and the earth. Everything, the earth and all that is therein. You know, I love when the word of God says, the earth and all that is therein, the seas and all that is therein, the heavens and the heavens of heavens, it is him who made it.
Amen.
And in him all fullness dwells.
Amen.
That's why we need to be rooted in this word of God. Because the word of God, it is all that we need. I came to discover that all answers that we need, they are found in the word of God.
Amen.
Whatever we need, God has already made a way where there seems to be no way. Praise be to God. Hey, we have a good God. He's our God. And he's our Father. We are called by his name. Hey! I'm called by the name of God.
Amen.
You know how beautiful that is? You're called by the name of the maker of heaven and the earth.
Amen.
Have you ever sat down and imagined that? That you're the son of the Most High God? Huh? Hey. The word of God testifies of Jesus Christ. He says in John 4:39, search the scriptures, for they are the ones which testify about me. They testify about Jesus Christ. The word of God also, it is the power of God unto salvation. Romans 1:16 says, for I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God to salvation of the Jews and also of the Gentiles. Praise be to God.
Amen.
The word of God, the gospel of Jesus, it is the power of God unto salvation. For we know that there is no other name that men shall be saved, but in the name of Jesus Christ. Hey! Praise be to God.
Amen.
You know, when we have been given a name, and this name is the name that is above every other name. We are told that every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And now we have been given his name. It is the power of God unto salvation. When you're preaching, we need the word of God. It is how you can convince people that because it is only Jesus. He said John 14:6 that I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father but through me. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Jesus is the only way. He is the only way. There is no any other way. There is no, and that's why we need to tell people that there is no other way, but the way is Jesus Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation.
Amen.
My time is over. Righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. That is in Romans 1:17. It shows the righteousness of God. It also reveals the wrath of God, because the word of God gives us also the, as in, it shows all the signs of God. You're able to know the righteousness of God. You're able to know that you're the righteousness of God, and it reveals that. And also reveals the wrath of God against all unrighteousness and ungodliness. Romans 1:18. It is the source of hope. We find it Romans 15:4. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of scriptures might have hope. Praise be to God.
Amen.
That's why we're able to encourage one another. Because of the word of God. When you learn what the apostles did, what David did, what Abraham, what Isaac did, we are able to get hope. We are able to know who God is. Praise be to God.
Amen.
It is a source of health. This you find in Proverbs chapter 3. I would encourage all of us to read Proverbs after this. It encouraged me a lot. Proverbs 3:8, it says, it shall be health to the navel and marrow to thy bones. It is a source of peace. If you need peace, you know, Jesus said, peace I give unto you.
Amen.
Not the peace that the world keepeth I give unto you, but the peace, my peace I give unto you. Let your hearts not be troubled.
Amen.
Let them not be afraid. Praise be to God.
Amen.
I want, those who come from where I come from know there is no difference between R and L. So don't worry. So, there is a peace you have been given. There is a peace you have been given. Peace that surpasses all human understanding. Do you want peace? It is found in Jesus Christ. It is found in the word of God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
In Proverbs 3:17, our ways are ways of pleasantness, that it talks about wisdom and the word of God, and all our paths are peace. She's a tree of life to them that lay hold upon her, and happy is everyone that retaineth her. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Proverbs 4:22 says, for they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh.
Amen.
Source of grace. Proverbs 1:9 says, ornament, it is an ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about thy neck. It makes us understand the fear of the Lord. That is Proverbs 2:5-6. And also gives us long life and peace. From the word of God, so many things are given about the importance of being rooted in the word of God. There's nowhere else you can be. The word of God, we need to be studious to get the word of God. How do you get rooted in the word of God? Thirst for the word of God. Next, please. Thirst for the word of God. Isaiah 55:1 says, oh, everyone that thirsts, come you to the waters. And he that has no money, come you buy and eat. Yeah, come buy wine and milk without money and without price. Wherefore do you spend money for that which is not bread? Bread. And your labor for that which satisfies not? Hearken diligently unto me and teach you that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness. Praise be to God.
Amen.
The word of God is able to make us fat in the spirit. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Because we are spirit, having a soul, and living in a body. We are spirit, having a soul, and living in a body. Just as the way you eat your food every day to make yourself grow, to make yourself healthy, that's why you need to get fatness in your spirit. Praise be to God.
Amen.
You need to thirst for the word of God. Because therein, are you able to know who you are in Jesus Christ? Are you able to know the price that Jesus Christ paid? Isaiah 53 sums it all up. What Jesus went through, so that we can be the children of the Most High God, so that we can inherit the richness of his glory. Praise be to God.
Amen.
The second way, please, when you find time, read Isaiah 55, all of it.
Amen.
Search the scriptures. That's the next way out to be rooted in the word of God. John 5:39 says, search the scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Meditate on the word of God. That's the third point of how to be rooted. Meditate on the word of God. That is Joshua 1:8, and think on it. Joshua, we read Joshua 1:8, where it says, you should think about it in the morning and in the night. Think about the word of God. Meditate. I love what Brother Willis told us during the BS. He told us that we need to meditate the word of God. Every day, take one verse of the Bible. Think about it. Think about it. Think about it. For me, there's a verse that has blessed me a lot this week. It is Acts 10:38, where it says, our God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with Holy Ghost and with power, went about doing good and healing all those who are oppressed of the devil, because God was with him. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Imagine that there is power in the Holy Spirit. We cannot do without the Holy Spirit of God. It is the word of God that is able to tell us who the Holy Spirit is, who we are in him, what he does in our lives. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And you need to think on it every day. That is in Philippians 4:8. All those characteristics you have been given of how we should be supposed to think are found when in Philippians 4:8, and they are found in the word of God. Set your minds on the things that are above and not below. Many of us always want to think based on the Babylonian system, and you know we have been redeemed from the world. The word of God tells us that we are no longer of the world. We are not of the world. We have been got out from the world. Praise be to God. Amen. And it is through thinking about this that you're able to know if your other people are going through some things, you're not supposed to go through them because you're the child of God. God has put a covering before you. That's why I believe Elisha, when they were faced by the great harem, he was able to tell his servant, he told God, open his eyes so that you can see those who are with us. That's why you're not supposed to fear. Because we play by a different set of rules. As a son of God, as a child in the kingdom of God, we are supposed to think in a different way. We are supposed to think based on the word of God. Because the word of God does not go with the system. We are taught the spirit of God always fights against flesh, and the two of them cannot work together. And to be carnally minded is to die. As in Romans 8 14, you shouldn't be carnally minded. You need to think on the things that are above. Set your minds on the things that are above. Praise be to God.
Amen.
That is found in Colossians 3:1. If you're then risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ seated on the right hand of God. Set your affection on the things that are above and not on the things on the earth. And then the next thing is to the word of God. Be a doer of the word of God. Today when we are learning about be rooted, there's something I loved what our sister said. We know so many other times we get familiar with God. So many other times we don't worship God for who he is. We are looking at people, what they think about us, what they are going to say, but that's not how it's supposed to be. You know, many, for me, one thing I've learned, so if you walk with, always follow your spirit and don't follow the crowd. Praise be to God. Amen. The crowd can lead you into the wrong things. Follow the word of God. Praise be to God. Amen. And be a doer. If we are saying today, be rooted in the word of God. God is going, one day you're going to stand before the judgment seat of Christ. You know, and we are going to give account of what we have always been listening. When we are taught about how to pray, when we are taught about how to be fervent in God, please let's be doers of the word of God. Romans 2:13 says, for not the hearers of the law are just before God, but the doers of the law shall be justified. In James 1:22-25 says, but be doers of the word. Be what? Doers of the word. Do I have a testimony in the house?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, hallelujah.
Nyanza
Mnyamaza, I will stay, and you know my minutes are over. But be you doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. For if any be a hearer of the word, and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself, and goes his way, and straightway forgets what manner of man he was. But whoso looks into the perfect law of liberty, and continues therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Hey, praise be to the Lord.
Amen.
We need to be doers of the word of God. God shows us the importance of being it. You are going to be blessed in your deed if you continue in the word of God. If you be a doer, if God tells you forgive, just forgive.
Amen.
Stop those other things of holding people in your heart.
Amen.
If he says what this way, don't stop being drunkard, stop being fornicators,
Amen.
Stop being this. Just do it. There is more joy in doing the word of God.
Amen.
And when you're able to pass through one test, your character is built and you're able to be an encouragement
Amen.
To many others. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Look yourself in it today. Praise be to God.
Amen.
We read that in Deuteronomy 6:6, where, you know, the, God told us we should put it in the post, and we should put it everywhere. We are supposed to be surrounded by the word of God.
Amen.
When you're going to the world, think about the word of God. Because if you're rotating in PIDs, in IMED, that's a long distance. Instead of thinking how someone is going to Kukusumbua, you're thinking about how you're going to be harassed, think about how God, what God has done in you. How he has made himself to be wisdom for you. How you're going to be the light of your world. Think about those patients. Pray about them. As in, look yourself in the word of God daily. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Speak the word of God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Speak what? The word of God. Speak the word of God. This I would insist on it today. And there's something I've learned. The power of life and death is in the tongue. And those who love the fruits thereof are going to eat of it. Praise be to God.
Amen.
There is power in our words. If you speak words of death, you know, death doesn't mean that this then die. It is the situation that you're in. If maybe you're in your studies and you're always thinking about suits, you're thinking about how this thing is so hard, then you're speaking death about it. And you're going surely to die. But speak life. Say you're a success in Christ Jesus. Because that's what Christ has made us to be. say that you're victor in this life, because that's what God says, that we are more than conquerors through Christ who loves us. Praise be to God. Speak the word of God to every situation. If it is in your relationship, speak the word of God. For me, I know there's power in our words. Most of the time, the things I speak always come to pass. And that these are what God always tells me. As in, we need to speak the word of God. I don't know how much I can explain that, because that's what we need as a church. For me, I actually wonder what's the difference between we believers and those other students who are out there. How are they going to know if we are born again? If we speak the same talk that they are talking. If we're always talking, if they're saying, what, you're also saying what. If they're saying na, you're also saying na. How are they going to differentiate? As in, we need to, if they're saying na, say hallelujah. As in, speak something different. Speak the word of God. Praise be to God. Because that's how you're going to get different results from the world. Praise be to God. And know that we are not of the world. And God has called us into the ministry of reconciliation. What GD preached to us, I love that word in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. That we have been given the ministry of reconciliation. Where we have been given the word of reconciliation. Where we are reconciling men back to God. And the only way we can reconcile men back to God is by speaking the word of God. Is by acting different from the world. Praise be to God. Yeah. That's what made the apostles different. I wondered what made the apostles so different in the book of Acts. And I came to understand they knew who they were in God. They spoke differently. They were not speaking what everyone else is speaking. Praise be to God. Yeah. And that's what God, my brothers and sisters, God is encouraging us to do today. Consequences of notes as I finish. Hosea 4:6. This reading is usually very powerful. Christ has made us to be priests. When you read the book of Revelations, chapter 5, it says, thanks be to God who has made us to be priests and kings unto our God. Also in Revelations chapter 1, upward view, I don't remember the verse, it says that we have been made to be priests and to be kings in the presence of God our Father. But read Hosea 4:6, it says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. Praise be to God. Amen. Imagine being rejected by God. And what does he say? That thou shalt be no more priest to me. Hey, you imagine that? And you know, priests are people who present people before God. As in, essentially, it means an intercessor, it means a prayer warrior, it means so many things. As in the relationship that you have with God, we have been made priests. But it says, if you reject knowledge, as in, essentially, if you reject even the word of God, if you love reading more of Ganon, more of all these other things, and you put the word of God aside, it says that I'm going to reject thee. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen. Amen.
Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children. You imagine that God forgets your children? For me, imagine the battles that I've fought for my family, and then you imagine that God says that he's going to reject thy children. As in, there are so many things as Christians who have gone through. For me, I imagine that I wouldn't want my children to go through. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And this comes, you don't want God to reject your children. And I want to tell you, my brothers and sisters, whatever you're doing right now, you're sowing seeds. Read Deuteronomy. There's that word that says that I've given you life or death. Choose life that you may live. Opportunity says about our generation. Always everything we are doing, it is for generational impaction. Praise be to God. Amen. If you walk in life, your generation is going to be a descendant of life. Praise be to God.
Amen.
But if you continue in death, your generation are going to be rejected before God. And it is because of the acts that you did. Praise
Amen.
Be to God.
Amen.
Romans 1:28 to 32, I'm not going to read it, but I'm going to read verse 1:28, and it says, and even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient. All these things, you see, you wonder why people are doing the things that they're doing. When I was in the United States, this word came to me very seriously. About there was so much promiscuity, there was so much homosexuality, there was so much ungodliness. And the thing that what for me came to me is that when you reject God, when you reject the knowledge of God, when you love the things of the world more than you love the things, God gives you over to a reprobate mind. You wonder why do you disobey your parents? You wonder why do you do the things you do? But it is because you're rejecting the knowledge of God. Praise be to God. Amen. The word of God is power. The word of God shows us the way to go. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And if you want to live that kind of life, God has told us, be holy as I am holy. Be perfect as I am perfect. That cannot come by your works. It comes by you being a studious student of the word of God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Study the word of God. In our Bible study, we have been reading that book of Timothy, where Paul told Timothy, study to show thyself approved unto men, a workman who rightly divides the word of truth. Praise be to God. That's what God has called us into. That we study to show ourselves approved unto men, rightly dividing the word of truth.
Amen.
I'm almost finishing. Proverbs 1:20-28. I love this word. When wisdom is crying out. Wisdom is always crying out. As in the word of God, which is wisdom, is always crying out. It was always telling us, oh, where are you? I want you. Well, come to me, come to me. That's what the word of God is telling us. It is always crying out that you may read it, that you may read the word of God and be established in the truth. And then I will read just verse 26. I mean, from 25. But you have set at naught all my counsel and put none of my reproof. I will also laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear comes. Praise be to God.
Amen.
That's what the word of God tells us. When you have a calamity, because you have refused to follow the word of God, then the word, as in wisdom, who is the Holy Spirit, who is God, as in, he looks at you, because now you have rejected knowledge. You have rejected what he has told you in his word. Now when your fear comes, when your calamity comes, he has got nothing to do. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Because you have rejected the word of God. My brothers and sisters, I urge you with all humility, let's study the word of God.
Amen.
In conclusion, wisdom is the principal thing. The next thing. Wisdom is the principal thing. That is Proverbs 4:7. Therefore get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Wisdom is the what? The principal thing. Therefore get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. Wisdom is the principal thing. The word of God is the principal thing, essentially. With all thy getting, get it. As in, when it means the principal things, it means the thing. As in, there is nothing else, it's the thing. It is the only way that we can be able to know what we are in Christ. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Romans 4:17-22. It gives, I will not read the whole of it, but it is an analogy. I wanted to give us an example of Abraham. One thing that kept Abraham going was his stand with God, with stand with the word of God that God had told him. We are told that he wavered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but he was strong in God, giving glory to God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And the things that God told him, they came to pass. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And that's what God tells us. Everything that he tells us comes to pass. Numbers 23:19, God tells us, God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. As he said, and shall he not do it? Or as he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Praise be to God.
Amen.
Everything in the word of God is real. We like it or not, the word of God works. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Because it is God breathed. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Just as the way God breathed into us life, the same way the word of God is breathed of God.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
And it is going to fulfill. That's why I put Isaiah 55:8 there. It is going to fulfill that which God has sent it to do. That's why you need to stand strong in the word of God. If there is anything else you should be loved to do, stand with the word of God. Don't stand with the wisdom of men. Praise be to God.
Amen.
But stand with the wisdom of God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Isaiah 55:8 as I finish. For my thoughts are not your thoughts. Hey, that's God telling us. For my what? My thoughts. My what?
My thoughts.
And not your what? And not your thoughts. Neither are your ways my ways. Says who?
The Lord.
My thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are my ways your ways. Your ways my ways, says the Lord. He says, let's read verse 9 together from there. For the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Praise be to God.
Amen.
For as the rain, let's continue. For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not hither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater. So shall not my word be that goes forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereunto I sent it. Praise be to God.
Amen.
That is God telling us what he says. Praise be to God. He says his word shall never return to him void. It is going to fulfill everything that he has spoken. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And when you study the word of God, when you stand in the word of God, hey, it never returns void. When God says whatever he says, he fulfills it.
Amen.
God says that the word shall never be broken. It shall never pass away. As in heaven and earth shall pass away, but the words that are spoken unto them will never pass away. Praise be to God.
Amen.
That's why we need to be rooted. We need to stand strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Praise be to God.
Amen.
And I know that the Holy Spirit is always with us. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Helping us to understand. He says in John 14 and 15 and also 16, about the Holy Spirit. And in one, he says that I will never leave you comfortless, but I'll give you another comforter. There's even the Spirit who is going to tell you about all the truth. Praise be to God. It is the Holy Spirit who helps us understand the truth. He helps us know what the truth is in the Word of God. He illuminates our mind with the Word so that we are always rooted and grounded in Him. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you for encouraging me as I've encouraged you. We can stand up and as we conclude.